Bonjour. We are back after a break of 3 days. And this will be the last video for this chapter. We will conclude this chapter today. This is the 7th video for this chapter. This chapter is long. In itself, it is long. It had 120 plus problems. And I've covered many more topics that are there in the book. What are these topics? The main one is rounding up, rounding down, rounding off, truncation, valeur approché, par défaut, par excès, arrondi, troncation. So that is not there in the book. We covered that. And then we did notation scientifique in a little bit more detail than in the book. And now we come to something called notation ingénieure de nombre. So this is what will be the... This is the only topic we will do in this video, the 7th video for this chapter. And there won't be any problems from the book to do on this. And then we will move on to the next chapter. Okay, so what is engineering notation of a number? That is very similar to scientific notation. It is a way of writing a number. And for each number, just like there is only one way you can write it in scientific notation, there is only one way you can write it in engineering notation. For some numbers, this you will notice, you will discover for yourself, the engineering notation is the same as a scientific notation. But it is not the same for all numbers. Okay, so it is similar to scientific notation. It takes this form, a into 10 to the power n. And we had done this for scientific notation. I will not go into explain the scientific notation. Okay, let me just say it briefly. You have to write A here as a number, as a decimal number, with one only one digit before the decimal point, avant la virgule, and that digit cannot be zero. And then you adjust N accordingly so that you get the number. In engineering notation, now we're doing engineering notation, A, this first number, can be any decimal number with 1 to 3 digits. So in scientific notation, you only had to have one digit, but in engineering notation, you have 1 to 3 digits, which this number can be positive or negative, other than 0. Before the decimal. So that means you have to have something that is 1 here, anything from 1 to 999. 1 to 3 digits. You cannot have 0 because 0 is not allowed, but you can have anything 1 to 999 followed by the virgule and the any number of digits after. And here's the tricky bit, the n is a positive or negative integer, just like it was for the scientific notation, but that is a multiple of 3. So in scientific notation, you could have here 10 to the power 1, 10 to the power 2, 10 to the power 3, 10 to the power 4, 10 to the power minus 6, 10 to the power minus 7. But in engineering notation, this n has to be a multiple of 3. So it can be 10 to the power 0, it can be 10 to the power 3, it can be 10 to the power 6, it can be 10 to the power 9, but it cannot be 10 to the power 7. It cannot be 10 to the power 1. It cannot be 10 to the power 2. It cannot be 10 to the power minus 4. 10 to the power minus 3? Okay, because minus 3 is a multiple of 3. We'll take examples. It will become easier. So suppose we have this number, 20,000 is equal to 2 into 10 to the power 4. Correct? 20,000 is equal to 2 into 10 to the power 4. This is scientific notation. I'm writing SN here in the rest of this video to indicate scientific notation. How would you write it as engineering notation? This is obviously not engineering notation because that 4 is not a multiple of 3. So how can you write it? Very simple. This is 20,000. No? So you make 20 into 10 to the power 3. There you are. 20 into 10 to the power 3. Okay, so this is 2 digits, which is allowed because it's 1 to 3 digits. And this n here is 3, which is a multiple of 3, of course. So this is the engineering notation of this number. So 20,000 can be only written in this way for scientific notation, can only be written like this for engineering notation. What is the benefit of engineering notation? We'll come to that in a couple of minutes. We'll take a few more examples. So just as for scientific notation, each number can be written in engineering notation in only one way. That's what I just said. 20,000 can only be written like this in engineering notation. There is no other way to write it that will satisfy this condition as well as this condition. So let's take more examples. So you have 23.456. So what is this here? In scientific notation, it is 2.3456 into 10 to the power 1. No problem there. For engineering notation, what will it be? See, it's already two digits before the decimal. It's not. It's already between 1 and 9999. So we can leave it as such. So engineering notation will be 23.456 into 10 to the power 0. Of course, we remember 10 to the power 0 is equal to 1. So 23.456 into 10 to the power 0 is the engineering notation of this number. But is 0 a multiple of 3? Yes, of course. 0 is a multiple of 3. You multiply 3 by 0, you get 0. So 0 is, of course, a multiple of 3. Let's take another one. Minus 678,000. So in scientific notation, it is minus 6.78 into 10 to the power 5. For engineering notation, what will it be? We want a multiple of 3 there. 5 is not a multiple of 3, so we can make it 10 to the power 3. So we'll get minus 678 into 10 to the power 3. This is the engineering notation of this number. Okay? This is just 3 digits long. That satisfies this condition. Okay, and 3 is a multiple of 3. Let's take a small number, 0.00024. This is 2.4 into 10 to the power minus 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Four digits, you have to move this to the right, so then it becomes 10 to the power minus 4. What will it be in engineering notation? It will be 240 into 10 to the power minus 6. So, how do you come to that? See, any other thing you do, you will not get. You have to take either 10. If you take 10 to the power minus 3 here, then you will get 0.24 into 10 to the power minus 3. You cannot have 0 alone in front of the virgule for engineering notation. So you multiply it by another 100, so 1000, you get 240 into 10 to the power minus 6. I run out of page here, so that's why I've continued it on the top. See, 0.00024 is equal to 0.24 into 10 to the power 3. Correct. Here it is multiple of 3. So this condition is satisfied, but here you have 0 before the virgule, so this condition is this condition here, any decimal number with 1, 2, 3 digits other than 0 is not satisfied. So this is neither scientific notation or engineering notation. Okay, so now let's try to see what is the advantage of using EN. Now if you remember this table here when we started this chapter about 3 weeks ago, this was on Greek and Latin prefixes, correct? These were the Greek prefixes, these are the Latin prefixes. Now these go all in multiples of 3, 10 to the power 24, 21, 18, 15, 12, 9, 6, 3. And these two are not recommended, hecto and deca, but then you have 10 to the power 0, which is 1. Then 10 to the power 3, which is milli, 10 to the power minus 6, which is micro, 10 to the power minus 9, which is nano, and here also you have kilo, mega, giga, tera, peta, so on and so forth. So the advantage of what is the advantage of using EN is that they are convenient to use with Greek and Latin prefixes. because they Greek and Latin prefixes also go up in multiples of 3, 10 to the power, each is different from the other by 10 to the power 3. It is 10 to the power 21, if you multiply it by 10 to the power 3, which is 1000, you will get 10 to the power 24. So now remember, I always said these prefixes can only be used when you have units. If you just have a number, you never use. Prefix means it comes before something. So it will be kilometer, kilogram, millisecond, microsecond, nanosecond, picometer, nanometer, micrometer. All of these, only when there is a unit. Microgram, nanogram, picogram. So, only when there are when there are units, can you, then it is convenient to use engineering notation. So, if you have 20,000 meters, if you write it in scientific notation, it is 2 into 10 to the power 4 meters. Absolutely correct. But in engineering notation, it is 20 into 10 to the power 3 meters. Because you have to get a multiple of 3 there. And this, 10 to the power 3 meters, we know is, what is 1000 meters? Kilometers. So we can straight away write 20 kilometers. Why have we put a multiplication sign there? I don't know. Okay. So it is 20 kilometers. Right. So, let's take another example. 0.000576 seconds s is equal to 5.76 into 10 to the power minus 5 seconds. This is scientific notation. If I write it in engineering notation, it is 57.6 into 10 to the power minus 6. But 10 to the power minus 6 is micro. 10 to the power minus 6 is micro. So, you can write that as 57.6 microseconds. I've expanded it here just in case you don't remember what that. That's a Greek letter called mu. Okay. So, that is it. Every number can be written. Some numbers, I don't have an example, maybe I'll write one here. Some numbers are the same in scientific notation as well as engineering notation. The simplest is 1000. So 1000 is equal to 1 into 10 to the power 3. This is SN. But because this is also a multiple of 3 and this is one digit here, which is not 0, we can write is equal to 1 to the power 3. The same thing. This is engineering notation also. Okay, so here we go. This is your video homework, ungraded for, so these are the numbers, 0.123 seconds, 0.678 meters, 23,478 grams, 234,789 grams, 2,134 meters, 2, 3 is bytes. What units are bytes? Bytes are what are used to store digital information. Okay, so you have to fill in scientific notation, you have to fill in engineering notation, and then you have to write the same number, what you have here with the engineering notation, with the prefix, just like I have done here. And finally, on this topic, your calculator also has a key to do this. On most calculators, it's called FSE key. On some calculators, it's called something else. But most calculators are capable of converting a number to scientific notation, engineering notation. So you can always use a calculator if you don't want to use your brain. Here, of course, I want you to not use a calculator to do this. I want you to learn. And once we do this, this chapter will be finished. One final point, in the last homework, I asked some of you to redo and submit some problems. You have to still do that. And to two of you, I asked a specific question. Neither of you have responded. Please do so, because without that, I will not be able to continue teaching you. Okay? So you know who you are. Okay, so I will stop here. It's a short video. Finally, once for once, we have a small video, and I will try to have the video for the next chapter up very quickly. The next chapter we will do from the book is a geometry chapter. It is chapter 10 in the book. And again, I will teach you a little bit more than there is in the book, but it is a very short chapter. The number of problems indeed are only 60. That is half of what we had in this chapter 1, chapter 10. If I can reach the book, I'll get it for you. Yeah, just hang on. Here we are. Ouch, I hurt my knee. That's okay. So this is the chapter we will start on. Étudier les faits d'engrandissement réduction. So this is on enlarging and reducing a figure. For example, you have a figure like that, you can enlarge it, that sort of thing. And here, this page 148 is got the cours, what we will learn. J'apprends le cours, agrandissement réduction, effet sur les longueurs et les angles, effet sur les airs et les volumes. And you'll see that the number of problems in this chapter are just 59. So this chapter will go fairly quickly, though here I will teach you a little bit more than is there in the book. We will talk about something called homotheti. Okay, so this is where I stop. I will upload this video, and please submit this table filled in. This should take you about 5 minutes at most before this evening. Okay.